Well, it's been nearly 1,000 days since Private First Class Bradley Manning was arrested on suspicion of having passed classified military material to the website WikiLeaks. Manning has yet to stand trial, but will have a pretrial hearing next week. A group called the Bradley Manning Support Network is organizing over 24 rallies around the world this weekend to get out the word. Joining me now from San Francisco, site of one of those rallies, is Jeff Patterson of the Bradley Manning Support Network. Jeff, thanks for being here.
Absolutely, no problem.
Now, Manning has been in prison for 3 years and has gone through multiple pretrial hearings, but is still waiting for an actual trial. What will happen in court this week?
Well, we have a pending motion to dismiss all charges based on Bradley having not received a speedy trial. He's guaranteed under military law a trial within 120 days under rules of court-martial 707. The military has gone far beyond those 120 days. As you mentioned, he's nearing 1,000 days without a trial. And we have events in 70 different locations around the world this weekend to protest that fact.
Now, the charges against Manning, if proven, don't necessarily make him a sympathetic character, and a lot of people feel that way right now. Why is this a cause that you've chosen to take on?
Well, there are a lot of people around the world that do see the vast benefit of what Bradley Manning provided to the world. And that was basically, he released data of government wrongdoing and of war crimes. We know, we have a much better idea of what our government did with our tax dollars in Iraq and Afghanistan and Guantanamo than without him. And it's important to remember that no single person was harmed because of the release of this information. And there was no harm to our foreign policy beyond Hillary Clinton, you know, having to speak to some people. So we're looking at a young man who was trying to do the right thing by exposing wrongdoing that harmed nobody. He was 22 years old at the time, an Army private, and yet he's facing life in prison. And if we look at just HSBC, the banking money laundering settlement, $1.9 billion last week, and yet not one banker is actually going to prison for those high crimes. And yet again, this young 22-year-old who's trying to do the right thing.
What's really the key issue here for you and your group? Is it that you don't really see that much wrong with the crime that he committed, that you think it may even be honorable in some ways? Or is it the fact that he hasn't received a speedy trial as guaranteed by the Constitution?
Well, he hasn't received the speedy trial, and he was tortured for 9 months by Marines at the Guantanamo Marine Base, something that the military judge in this case, Colonel Denise Lind, has admitted to. And in fact, you know, and then he's facing life in prison. So it's, yes, he may have broken military regulations, but is the punishment of life in prison for trying to do the right thing equal to these military regulations that were violated? And if he is, you know, if a reasonable person could say, well, we need to punish this kid. But the reasonable person would also look at the 1,000 days and the 9 months of torture he's endured and say, okay, the military has made its point. You know, at this point, if he's facing decades in prison, we're talking about a young man who's going to be left behind after these wars are long done, and yet the benefits to society from knowing what happened with our tax dollars far outweighed the inconvenience and, you know, having Hillary Clinton having a bad day or two over this information.
All right, Jeff Patterson of the Bradley Manning Support Network, thank you for your time this afternoon.
Absolutely.
Well, President Obama did promise more transparency in his administration, but critics say the administration has failed to deliver on that promise.